are joined by Panthers All-Pro running back, Christian McCaffrey. Welcome to the show, Christian.
It
is good to have you. These guys love you. They just want you to know what I'm going to echo. You smell tremendous. It's probably, I'm sure you would too, but he's got the Old Spice shirt on. Yeah. So why don't we start there? You're with Old Spice here.
Yeah, so Old Spice just dropped their Ultra Smooth line. It's not only a body wash, but it's a deodorant too. And it's available. So I brought you guys some. You're allowed to wear it too.
I'm allowed to wear it.
She doesn't need to.
No, and it's available at Walgreens. So anybody who
appreciate
wants to smell fresh, low-key, check it out.
Maybe if you wear this, I will walk in every morning and say,
not necessarily.
You smell tremendous.
Instead of talking about me, let's talk about Christian. 1,000 yards receiving, 1,000 yards rushing. You were this close last year in the 2018 season. Didn't quite get it. You know the full list of people who've done it, right?
Yep.
Roger Craig, Marshall Faulk, you.
Yep.
Your top 10 pick, you're a superstar at Stanford, could have won the Heisman. Even with those expectations, did you anticipate this level of accomplishment this early in your career?
You know, it's tough. You never really anticipate a whole lot, you know, and I definitely set individual goals and I have visions for myself and, you know, I have a high standard for myself. But I think once I started taking it, you know, one day at a time, it became easier for me. I had more fun with the game. I had more fun with my training and taking the process one day at a time, you know, one treatment at a time. And after that, it became more fun and started having more success. But at the end of the day, I mean, and you guys know this better than anybody, you know, winning's the most important thing in the world. And you can have all the individual success, but at the end of the season, you know, if your team's not in the playoffs, if your team, you know, didn't have a shot for the Super Bowl, it's, you know, you're a little bit bitter. So, you know, I'm hoping we can turn things around.
Unfortunately, your team didn't get a chance to perform as well as you probably would have wanted this year. And a lot of that has to do with the fact that Cam Newton went down with injury. I wonder if a healthy Cam Newton if we could see the Cam Newton of old back again, if he is to get healthy, because there was a lot of criticism about Cam, you know, sort of towards the end of this season, whether he'd even be back, whether you could help another team. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, it's tough. Injuries are a tough reality of the game. And, you know, Cam's a guy who, when healthy, is one of the most dynamic players in the league. And for me, coming in as a rookie, knowing that he was going to be my quarterback, I was extremely excited. And we've seen what he's done when he's healthy. I mean, he'll fight for every single inch, you know, even when he's hurt. He's a heck of a teammate, good leader, very unique personality. But, you know, when you really get to know him, when you really get to play with him, you see all the extra stuff he does. And for me, when you see a quarterback, you know, fighting for an extra 3-4 yards when guys are teeing off on him, jumping over piles in the end zone. That's something you can rally behind. It's something you can really respect. You know, somebody who's fighting for every inch, to score a touchdown, to get a first down, whatever it may be. So
we're here for Super Bowl week. So and obviously the 49ers and Chiefs are playing. You guys played the 49ers. I believe they held y'all to what, 13 points?
Yep.
What's the hardest thing about facing this defense?
Yeah, they got such a good D-line. And there's a difference between having a good D-line who has a bunch of good pass rushers and a good D-line who has a bunch of good run stoppers. And when you look at them, they have both. And they have, you know, two of the, you know, best, in my opinion, when I've played so far, two of the best linebackers I've played this year, Quan Alexander and Fred Warner. And they play so well together. They rally to the football. I think when you look at team speed as a defense, as me, you know, me as a running back, I look at, how do they run to the ball? Not just in the first quarter, in the fourth quarter. And then Richard Sherman leading that secondary. You know, not only do you have a heck of a player, but you have somebody who's been there and done that. And communication is everything. And so you can see the way they communicate. And you know, obviously, it's going to be a heck of a test with an offense like the Chiefs and what Pat Mahomes has done and Andy Reid has done. So. I'm excited for the game, but I think the biggest thing about that defense is the D-line. It starts up front, so that'll be a huge test when you have a D-line who can stop the run and rush the passer.
You were an offense unto yourself, really, for the Panthers this year. And part of last year, particularly once Cam went out. But still, even with that responsibility, there are times you got to get in there, block, you got to chip a blitzing linebacker. For the Chiefs, that's going to be almost all they ask their running backs to do, catch screen passes and help with the blitz pickup. As a young player, Chiefs have a young running back as well. How difficult is that? What are the strategies for it when some monster like this guy's coming in hot and it's only you, between you and him and the quarterback?
Yeah. I played against James one time in the preseason. I was actually lucky. I don't even think I was in at the same time as him. So very fortunate you retired. But no, it's, I mean, as a running back who, you know, likes to get out on my check down and you know, get the ball, it's tough because the whole week you're preaching, look, if nobody's blitzing, you chip that guy. And so when we played, you know, the Niners, it was, if I know they're not blitzing, I'm going, you know, I'm going to 97 and I'm chipping Bosa and I have to be very, very cognizant of that at all times. And, you know, when you are an offense like the Chiefs who relies on your checkdowns, you rely on your backs, you know, getting open and making somebody miss in the passing game, it becomes tough because it's a whole nother element of the game that you have to take into consideration. And it does a lot to an offense and, you know, obviously helps the defense out.
Listen, man, you got a real famous dad, you know what I'm saying? Like, what was it like growing up around all those guys? Like,
it was a lot of fun. You know, I was very fortunate to have, you know, my mom and dad who did such a good job. I have three brothers. I got an older one and two younger ones, and everything we did was together. And so we were always competing, always doing stuff with each other. You know, it was two-on-two basketball in the yard, you know, knee football, you know, playing out in the snow. And, you know, it was good because they didn't care what we did, but they just cared that we did it 100% and put everything into it. And, you know, I'd like to think I took advantage of using him as an outlet I could lean on.
I'm sure your dad told you just about as much as he could pass along of what to expect when you're actually playing. I'm sure you came to work with him. I'm sure you met the guys. I'm sure you were in the locker room. But now that you're in the NFL, tell me something about the last couple of years that he couldn't prepare you for.
Well, there's so much, you know, the game's changed so much since when he played. You know, he can prepare you, I guess, he can prepare your attitude and kind of mold different things on how to approach the game. But for me, you know, I'm my own man. And, you know, coming into the league, it's good that I learned from players on my team who have done it right. Guys like Luke Kuechly, you know, guys who set the standard of you know, what it's like to be a pro. And, you know, I was fortunate for that. So I think it's a constant learning process, and it's a constant process to figure out what your formula is, you know, off the field, how you take care of your body, you know, who's going to take care of your body, you know, who you call for advice. And at the end of the day, it's just taking little pieces from everybody and making them, you know, specifically your own.
Couple questions on Luke Kuechly. He's one of the greatest players of his era. He obviously just stepped away from the game. Did you see that coming? And what was your reaction when you saw the video?
Yeah, I didn't see it coming 100%. You know, he had called me the day he said he was going to announce it. And, you know, it's bittersweet for me because I want to play with him my whole career. And he's a guy who, you know, is a pretty model football player, in my opinion. A guy who works his butt off day in and day out, plays the right way. And, you know, somebody who's very easy to look up to as a young player coming in the league. And I didn't really see it coming, but I'm so happy for him. You know, I mean, he's a guy who went out on his own terms, and I have the utmost respect for that. You know, he played 8 seasons. He probably had 1 million tackles, so.
Yeah,
he did. He had 1 million tackles.
Yeah, 1 million, that's what he said. So, you know, he went out on his own terms, and I couldn't be more happy for him. He's probably hunting and fishing somewhere right now, enjoying
life. All right, so big question. Everybody want to know, who you got winning?
I mean, I hope they both lose. I don't know.
No draft
me,
class
really
of 2017 pride? You
no,
and
I,
best
I,
quarterback, best running back?
I got a lot of buddies on both teams. I root for certain players, but and I'm a fan of the game, so I'll watch, and I hope it's a good game. But I'm dead serious. I don't care who wins.
Last one before you go. When you were a little kid running around Broncos facility, did you know then how crazy Shannon Sharp is? Or you
yes.
just, you did?
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah.
Maniac, even then.
I would play Power Rangers with him when I was a kid. I was always a green Power Ranger. I don't know which one he was, but I mean, he's been a personality his whole life. I think I was at the game in Foxborough. I mean, I couldn't remember, but just from stories I hear, I was so young. I was at the game in Foxborough where he picked the phone up and said, call the National Guard. we're killing the Patriots. But, you know, he's been a personality his whole life. And it's been good being able to catch up with him throughout the years. And, you know, it's funny how things go in full circle.
He talks about how proud he is of you, man. It's really, really impressive. It's really, yeah. it's hard. James alluded to it. you get big shoes to follow, and you've more than filled your role. You've done a great
thank
job.
You.
Man.
Appreciate
Christian,
it.
Thank you so
you.
Much. Congratulations
yeah,
on an amazing
it.
Season. Continued success. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. Also, be sure to check out more of the best clips from First Things First, or go watch a few segments from our other shows on FS1.